Here we shall solve one problem. Here the counter circuit will be given to us and we are supposed to find out the sequence in which the counting will take place. In our normal counter design, we usually get the counting sequence and design the circuit. But here the circuit is given and we are supposed to find out the counting sequence. So the problem will be very interesting. So here is the circuit given to us and we are supposed to find out the counting sequence here. So at first we shall have to observe two issues. Issue number one is that whether all the flip-flops are same or they are different. Here in this case, all the flip-flops are JK flip-flops, but it might happen that some of them are T, some of them are SR and some of them are JK. So that can also happen. Next observation, are all the flip-flops getting clock pulse from the main CP, main clock pulse? So let me check. This flip-flop, that is C, is getting clock pulse from the main source and this flip-flop is getting clock pulse from the main source, but this flip-flop is getting clock pulse from the previous flip-flop. So that's why this counter is asynchronous. So that will make your problem little bit harder. So now let me discuss that what are the steps to be done. So here you have made one empty table with the headers. So present state ABC and next states ABC. So now here we are having the flip-flop inputs, that is for flip-flop A, B and C. Now we shall fill up these columns and we shall complete our answer of this question. So here is the solution we are starting. So at first observe the circuit diagram. See, here JA, here JA means this one is having B and C. So you are writing the same here. So JA is BC. What about KA? KA is B bar. So from the circuit we are going to write them. And this G and K will be 1-1 for B flip-flop. And this G and K will be our A bar. And it is negative S triggered. This is negative S triggered. That means when this C will be having a transition from the C output, will have the transition from 1 to 0. As the inputs are 1-1, then the flip-flop output will get complemented. That means when this C will have a transition from 1 to 0, then the output will get complemented and it is for the flip-flop B. It is for the flip-flop B. So now let me go for the sequence detection. So at first we are considering the starting sequence is 0, 0, 0. So BC will be 0, B bar will be 1, they are permanently 1, A bar is 0 bar, that is 1 and 1. So they are getting clock pulse from the main source, that is A flip-flop and C flip-flop. They are getting clock pulse from the main source and B flip-flop is getting clock pulse from the C. So now here for 0-1 input, output will be 0. For 1-1 input, output will be complemented of C. So we are using the characteristic table of JK flip-flop, which we discussed so many times. That is for 0-0, output will remain same, that is QT. For 0-1, output will be 0. For 1-0, output will be 1. And for 1-1, output will be Q bar T. So here we are having this 0-1, so output will be 0. And for 1-1, output will be C bar. So that's why I have written this one. So here we are getting a transition from 0 to 1, not from 1 to 0. So B is not getting any clock pulse. So the previous output of B will remain the same. So that is the next sequence. So I'm writing this sequence here. That whatever the next state, I'm writing the next state here, making it as a present state. Now, BC, here BC is, if you do the ending, it is 0, B bar is 1, and here A bar is 1 and 1. Here A bar is 1 and 1. So 0, 1, output will be 0. For 1 and 1, the output will be complemented. So C was 1, so that will become 0 here. So now C is having a transition from 1 to 0. So as JB, KB are 1-1, so B will get complemented. So I think you are getting this logic. When C is having a transition from 1 to 0, then B will get the clock pulse. That means as the inputs are 1-1, so the B will get complemented. So B was 0 here, so I have written 1 here. Because C had a transition from 1 to 0, so that could provide a clock pulse to B. So this is the new state. I am writing this one here. BC is 0, B bar is 0 and A bar is 1 1. So 0 0 means no change. So A will remain the same. 1 1, I shall consider that one later. So 1 1 is here. So C has got a transition from 0 to 1 because the output has got complemented. So there is no transition from 1 to 0 for C. So that's why B didn't get any clock pulse. So the previous output of B will remain same. So I'm going for 0 1 1. BC 1. B bar is 0. Here we are having this A bar. So A bar is 1 here because A is 0. So A bar is 1 here. So for 1 0, the next output will be 1. For 1 1, the output will be 1 to 0. Because 1 1 means output will get complemented. So here we are having one transition from 1 to 0 for C. So B is getting the clock pulse. So this 1 will get complemented to 0 because it is having the inputs 1 1 here. So now going for this 1 0 0. So BC, B bar, and here we are having this A bar. So 0 1 means next state 0. 0 0 means the state will remain unchanged. And here we are not getting any transition in C. So B didn't get any clock pulse, so B will remain the same. In this way, we are doing it. So again, we should put here 0 0 0, but 0 0 0 we have considered already. So let me put a line. So what is untouched here? So I go for say 5, 1 0 1. So that we didn't consider earlier, so I am considering it right now. So BC is 0, B bar is 1, and here we are having this A bar, so that will be 0 0. So 0 1 means 0. Here 0 0 means no change. So here we are having this C has got no change. So that's why we are, this B will remain same. Okay. So now we shall go for the next one, that is 6 and 7 that we didn't consider. So going for 6. BC is 0. B bar is 0. B is 1 here. B bar is 0. So now going for A bar. So that is 0. So here we are getting 0 here. So no change. 0 means no change. So previous output was 1. So that should be 1 here. So 0 0 means no change. So it will remain as this. And also C didn't provide any clock pulse to B. So that's why it will remain same as this. So now going for the last combination, that is 1 1 1. BC, B bar, A bar. So 1 0 means 1. 0 0 means no change. So 1 will remain. So C didn't give any clock pulse to B. So B will remain unchanged. So in this way, we have got all the next states from all 8 possible combinations of the present state. So now let me complete the sequence diagram. 0 to 1, 1 to 2, 2 to 3, 3 to 4, and then 4 to 0. So we should be having this 0 to 1, 1 to 2, 2 to 3, 3 to 4, and then 4 to 0 back again. So that is one portion we have covered. Now next one is from 5 to 1. So from 5, it will be coming to the state 1. What about the next one? That is 6 and 7, they remain in the same state. So 6 and 7 will remain in the same state like this. So these states will be known as non-self. So these two states will be known as non-self starting state. So if such problems come in your exam, so always see that what are the flip-flops are given, are they heterogeneous or homogeneous. So accordingly, we are supposed to select the respective characteristic table, and then we shall have to check whether the circuit is synchronous or asynchronous. So accordingly, you are supposed to solve the problem. Thanks for watching this video.